Joseph, it's great to have you back on the show. I'm excited to get to talk about the new record and the new single and all the crazy goings on that comes with being a musician and a business owner and all that good stuff. But first off, welcome back to the show, dude.
Hey, thanks for having me, man. I appreciate it.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Well, since the last time we talked, you guys came out with a new record, which I know is always a fun and a good thing and always welcomed by the fans. But tell us a little bit about the newest album for you guys.
Well, the newest album is called Found. And it's, you know, for us, this record, our fans have been waiting about 3 years for us to release a new record. So we had an EP come out, you know, a year and a half ago or so. Our fans really wanted a full-length album. And so what we were going to originally do with that EP was we were going to put 5 songs on it and then release a full album, including those 5 songs to make a, you know, 10 or 11 song album. We were like, you know what? We already released this EP. Let's give the fans a full album, brand new, with brand new songs on it that don't include the EP. We started writing again and we got back in the studio and we got it done. And our fans love it. It's been a, you know, Seventh Day Slumber's been around for a long time. So the journey has been awesome. And there's more things to write about the longer you've lived and the longer you've been in this industry.
For sure, which I think is a really great way to look at it. Because at least for some bands, and this would probably be the case for me, I think I would hit a point where I would be like, well, I feel like I've written about a lot and what else is left? And then sometimes you can kind of retread a lot of stuff, which doesn't always yield bad results or anything, but it's always nice when there is something fresh. Would you say there's any sort of a theme to the record, whether intentional or not at this point?
Yeah, the theme of this record, really, there was about a 5-year period where I was really struggling and with depression. I didn't even know what caused the depression, to be honest with you.
Right.
I was just bummed out, and I really feel like it had to do with feeding. I mean, you know, not getting fed, giving out every single night and helping people every single night. But me, myself, I wasn't getting fed. And actually, it was about 4 years that I went through that. And it just started to take its toll on me. And I gained over 100 pounds. I was running to food. You know, I never, you know, ran back to drugs or anything like that. But you know, I was running to things that were leaving me more empty than I was before. And instead of running to God, here I am running to other things. And I ended up gaining over 100 pounds. My wife is an amazing woman. She would pray for me. She knew that I was bummed out and I was burnt out. But I never lost my passion for helping other people. I just couldn't help myself.
Right.
I don't know if that makes any sense.
Right? Yeah, absolutely.
But I was embarrassed to even tell my pastors what I was going through. Because I'm like, you know, God delivered me from this $400 a day cocaine addiction. I was able to meet an amazing woman and be married, you know, for all these years and have 3 awesome kids and have a successful band and all these, you know, ministry and the whole thing. And then now I'm going through this. And I was almost embarrassed. And anyway, so the theme of this record is just about going through that journey. And even though I felt like I let God down again, like, you know, before I didn't know God and then I got saved, but after all God's done for me, then I run to all these other things to, you know, just because you don't run to drugs again doesn't mean you can't be addicted to something. This record is about that journey, but it's also just about encouraging others who have, you know, have felt empty inside and have felt lost. And that theme, you know, doesn't get old because there are people that are every day dealing with things, but cried out to God. My middle son said, Daddy, I miss you. And what's kind of unique about that and profound about it is that my kids, all 3 of my kids have traveled with me in a tour bus since they were born, basically.
Yeah.
And he said, I miss you. He wasn't talking about physically. And it was at that point that I was just like, God, I need you. And it was like, God's like, I never left. It was you. So that the theme of this record is about, you know, about that. It's about, you know, coming back to that place where I first fell in love with Jesus.
Wow. See, man, that's amazing. And I'm glad that, you know, being who you are, that you can actually talk about that. I know it took a while and I don't blame you in a sense, because I know that I probably would have been the same way about it. It's so easy to kind of feel like, you know, if you can't do it on your own, then somehow that means you're lacking in something. And you know, even when you're handing just stuff over to God, even not other human beings, somehow it feels like you shouldn't have to. And that's somehow this weird embarrassment that we as Christians can take on ourselves, which is just unfair to us and unfair to God and everyone around us. But man, it is so hard to get past that. And I'm glad that you're able to have gotten to a place where you can deal with that.
Absolutely. Well, I'm in a different place now. And let me tell you, this record, I mean, it was healing for me. It was part of my healing process writing this record. And it's helped a lot of people. You know, it's been out for a few months now, but it's helped so many people, but it's helped me. Like I'm getting ministered to by my own and getting encouraged by my own record. And that's why I know that God was doing something here, man. And, you know, it's crazy. Death was part of my healing.
Right. Well, dude, that's fantastic. I'm very happy that was able to do that, because I mean, creating art and writing, I know, can be kind of cathartic and healing in a lot of ways. And, you know, one can only think that if it's doing that for you, then it has to be doing things for other people as well. That's great, man.
Yeah. Another cool thing is we got to write with a lot of cool people on this, from guys in Disciple to some major songwriters out of Nashville. And one of the best parts about it is we didn't just give it over and say, hey, guys, can you write a record for us? We're busy.
Right.
Like, we just wanted input from other musicians, other artists, other writers, and because we wanted to do a project collectively with other people's input to make it the best Seventh Day Slumber that we could be. We're not trying to change our style or change the game or anything like that. We just want to be the best Seventh Day Slumber we can be with new elements and fresh new elements. And that's what this record is. So even, you know, you've heard about the message of the music, but man, the music itself, I feel like is a step above even some of the other Seventh Day Slumber stuff that we've written.
Nice, nice. Well, what do you think of all the stuff that's on the record? What do you think will be the most surprising to the most long-term hardcore Seventh Day Slumber fan?
We really felt like we didn't want to abandon those fans that love our worship stuff too. And so what we did was we took our favorite records not necessarily our favorite records, but I mean, we love them all, but our fans, our rock fans' favorite records, and you know, our worship fans, we have two records that we did for worship, and we took basically those records and kind of mashed them up and created this blend of our rock stuff, but with also the worshipful tones in there. And I don't know. I don't think it's going to really surprise anybody that we have, you know, worship songs on here. And our worship fans won't be surprised that, you know, well, this isn't like From the Inside Out or Oceans from the Rain.
Right.
You know, so we were really intentional about that. We wanted to make sure that we gave everybody something, you know, that they would latch onto and love.
Well, the single that's spinning right now on the rock side is called Sky is Falling. Tell us about that song specifically.
Sky is Falling is actually a song that, it was about actually a certain person.
Okay.
Who I won't get into all that, but it was just about a certain person that I had been helping to get through their issues. And it was like every time I would give advice or talk this person off the ledge, so to speak, and everything seemed fine, it would be like a month later, they come back with, now I'm going through this. And it was kind of always something.
Right.
And I would always tell that person, the person was struggling with addiction and suicide and depression and all those things. And first and foremost, I always say to get help, you know, to get professional help when it's something that serious. But at the end of the day, there are those who just always love drama. And so I'm not necessarily talking about mental illness. I'm talking about someone who just loves drama.
Right.
And we can spend our whole day helping that person, and it'll go right for like 2 weeks. And basically what we're saying in this song is we're trying to encourage people. It's only the end if you make it the end. You know, your life is not over. Take a deep breath, and we're going to reset and start over. And it's basically just a song about frustration, about, you know, but loving someone enough to be there. But this person just wants to be the victim.
Yeah.
And like I said, I understand that mental illness is a different thing than, than just someone who's just wants drama or wants attention, or, you know, you got to be so, nowadays you got to be very, very careful how you say things, because, you know, the political correctness police will come out and, you know, write you a message on Facebook. So I'm very careful about this, but it's just really about saying, you know what, even though you're going through this and have kind of put me through this, I'm still here. I'm still encouraging you. The sky isn't falling. You know, you think it is, but it's not. And you can still make it, but you got to go hard or go home.
That is a tough thing to handle because, I mean, it is very easy to talk about that and it come off in a bad way. But at the same time, I know what you mean. It does feel like everyone's had that person in their life at some point who just really has a hard time walking on the sunny side of the street ever. And, you know, we all go through hard things. And by all means, some people are going through more difficult things than the next person. But you have to be willing to let yourself be happy at some point and be able to find some sort of happiness in your life. And I mean, you know, and as Christians, a lot of times that happiness is and should be found through God. But, you know, even just other things. I mean, it's a matter of letting simple things bring you joy in some way. And sometimes that gets lost.
Yeah, it does. But if you're really a friend, and I'm just going to keep it real. If you're really a friend, you're really a true friend, then you got to be honest with that person. Sometimes you got to say, look, man, you've got to step your game up. You know, sometimes you have to be honest with that person and explain to them that you don't have to be a victim, that you can have victory in your life, but you have to want it and you have to go for it. People that have been through the same things you're going through have overcome, and you can too. And I don't mean be mean to that person.
Right.
I mean, just be honest. Like my son was honest when he said, Daddy, I miss you.
Yeah.
You know, he was honest. He's like, you're here, but you're not here, dude.
Yeah.
And it was definitely sobering to hear that. So yeah, but that's what that song's about. And also it is an encouragement. Like no matter what you're going through, it's not the end. You can make it. You can make it.
Yeah. Yeah. You have to put in some effort to get through life. I mean, that's just all there is to it for sure. Now, there's been some other things that are related, but as far as music and whatnot, but are a little bit different than just the record or just the band itself. But recently, of course, you guys have announced the lineup for the next big tour that you guys are putting together, which I'm always excited about because whenever you guys get this specific one announced, I'm always anxious to see who you got. So tell us about that tour. I know you know which one I'm talking about.
Yeah, well, we're excited. The City Rock Fest tour that's been my favorite tour for the past 3 years. Well, this is now the fourth year. Not that I don't love the other tours, but this one, you know, we get to be with our rock buddies that we've played with, you know, all over.
Yeah.
And we get to all be on tour together for 3 whole months and instead of just seeing each other at one of the major festivals. So, you know, it's buses traveling together and camaraderie and all that. But really what I love about it is the fans are excited.
Oh,
and
yeah.
And to see these rock, you know, the rock fans are like, oh, my goodness. Like all my favorite bands, I don't have to go. I can see them right here in my town. So we're excited. Disciple signed on again this year, which was really, really awesome. They had a new record that just came out, and we love those guys so much. You know, we have Disciple. Seventh Day Slumber just came out with a new record. Obviously, we're on that tour. Spoken, I mean, they are just killing the game now. And Matt, the lead singer of Spoken, has been doing this for so many years, and it's almost like he's like the only person I know that has reinvented himself in this way. Over the past 3 years or so, their fan base has just exploded.
Right.
And so, and he's been around for a long time. So their new music is just off the charts. So Spoken's on there. You have Random Hero, which is amazing. They're about to sign a record deal on Monday.
Oh, nice.
Those cats are awesome. And so you have The Protest is another young band that is amazing. So yeah, but one of the cool ones that, I mean, they're all cool, but one of the cool things about this is that we got these two bands that have never done it before, Wolves at the Gate, which is ridiculous. These guys are amazing, and you know, they've got some heavy, heavy stuff. It's different than Seventh Day Slumber, but man, that's what's cool about this tour is Wolves at the Gate on Solid State Records. They're on this tour. And then As We Ascend, which used to be We as Human,
mm-hmm.
and to have them on this tour is crazy. So it's a packed lineup. It's, I mean, it's big. It's, you know, it's the world's largest Christian tour. So Christian rock tour. I'm sorry, not Christian tour, because then that would mean that we're larger than Winter Jam, which is not possible.
You know? Well, that's all right. But I mean,
it's not
you know,
possible for anybody anywhere.
Right. Yeah. But I mean, but still, you guys are stacked seven deep, and that's pretty crazy for a touring rock show of any kind, much less a Christian rock show, man. I mean, that's fantastic.
Yeah, it's amazing. What and also, you know, all these bands, every one of these bands that are on the City Rock Fest tour has had a top five Billboard Christian rock hit within the past year.
Yeah.
So you have all relevant bands, all on Billboard, you know, Christian rock bands that have an awesome message. And it's, you know, you don't have to do any explaining, like, well, you know, they're on the tour, you know, and I know but their drummer's a Christian,
right?
You know, and having to finagle your way into making people believe they're a Christian band because the drummer and dad was a youth pastor. Like, nah, man, all these cats are Christian. All of them love Jesus. They're not ashamed to say Jesus. And yeah, they play clubs and yeah, they, you know, do that, play everywhere. But these guys, everybody on this tour is bold about the God they serve. And, you know, they're not slamming it down anybody's throat or anything. But, man, you know, you ask them, they'll tell you straight up.
Cool, man. Cool. Well, I hope that every night is packed out, because I think, especially when I was in college, dude, I would have so driven a very long distance to see this.
Yeah. Yeah, I hear you. Hey, me too, and I'm on this tour.
Right.
Like, if I wasn't on the tour, I'd still go to see these bands in one place.
Right. No, I hear you there, dude. I hear you there. Cool. Well, now, recently, I mean, earlier you kind of mentioned, you know, record deal kind of stuff. Now, a new venture for you is you just announced that you have started your own record label and you've already signed somebody. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, we started a label. You know, there's partners, and so I'm the president of the label. And so the label is actually the parent company is actually called Nashville Label Group LLC. So that's it's a limited liability company.
Okay.
But it's called, you know, Nashville Label Group is the parent company, and it'll have two labels two record labels.
Okay.
that are on that. And one is Rockfest Records, and the other one is called Burtonwood. Okay. Records. And so Burtonwood Records is more for contemporary Christian artists. We signed an artist by the name of Nathan Sheridan, who is an amazing, he's an amazing artist. I can't believe that this kid hadn't been signed yet. And so we're very excited to have Nathan Sheridan on Burtonwood Records. And then on Rockfest Records, we've signed a band called Amongst the Giants. They're in the vein of Under Oath, August Burns Red.
Okay.
And they are, I'm telling you, I'm going to send you a sneak peek.
Okay.
But their record, no one's heard any of their music yet. Maybe their demo stuff, but we just finished four songs with them. We're going to do the whole record, but four songs are finished. It was produced by Jeremy Holder, filler guitar player, and mixed by J.R. McNeely, who's done TFK and you name it, everybody.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Anyway, he mixed that record. And so we signed Amongst the Giants on Rockfest Records. And of course, we signed Seventh Day Slumber on Rockfest Records.
Naturally.
And so there are three other artists that we will be announcing, well, Monday. So you can take that and do what you want with that. But it's exciting. You know, we have, and anybody can start a record label, but to have major, major distribution. Oh, we had a major distribution company, actually the world's largest distribution company for music sold anywhere, Christian and mainstream. That announcement will be coming out in the next 2 to 3 weeks. I can't announce it right now due to legal reasons.
Sure.
And so anyway, it's a real record label. It's not like Joe Schmo said, yeah, man, I got, you know,
I've got a logo.
You know, yeah, I got a logo, man. We're a real record label with real partners and major distribution. And it's pretty amazing. I'm excited to be a part of this and to have partners that believe in me to run it, head it, and, well, own it. You know, it's pretty crazy. I'm excited. We've got some major announcements coming up in the near future. But for right now on Rockfest Records, you know, it's Amongst the Giants, Seventh Day Slumber. And then, like I said, Monday I'll be announcing some other stuff. But
okay.
Then Burtonwood Records, Nathan Sheridan, man, the kid is ridiculously amazing. His voice is beautiful. He's an amazing acoustic guitar player. Just he has a soulful voice. I can't wait for that. But like I said, the a lot of big things coming and a lot of records coming out. So
sweet deal,
we're excited.
Man. Awesome. Now, is there a place where people can keep up with those two labels online now? Do they have kind of an official landing page?
Rockfest Records is just rockfestrecords.com.
Okay.
And Burtonwood is burtonwoodrecords.com.
Okay.
Nashville Label Group, it'll be nashvillelabelgroup.com, but that site is being created right now. We just got the actual LLC for it and the trademark, and okay. Secretary of State had to sign off on it and all kinds of different things with that. It was but I can't believe, by the way, that nashvillelabelgroup.com was available. And
right,
and that's crazy. And that the name hadn't been trademarked, Nashville Label Group.
Yeah.
And so, because we were coming up with a name, we knew that Rockfest Records was going to be branded. It was part of branding for City Rockfest Tour.
Sure,
but,
yeah.
You know, Rockfest Records, we knew was going to be the rock label, and we knew that Burtonwood was going to be the rock label, but they both needed a place to kind of manage them, own them, you know, and do all the legal stuff and everything like that. And we were coming up with a name, and Nashville Label Group, I thought, well, that's real cool. Let's see if that's available. And sure enough, it was. And then we called an attorney, and they were like, yeah, the name's available for an LLC. And I was like, are you serious? They're like, yeah. I'm like, isn't this Music City and no one took Nashville Label Group?
This is probably the difference between you and me, because I doubt this did this to you. But if that would have been me, my first thought would have been like, okay, I'm going to double check my spelling. Because surely I must have missed something somewhere.
Well, there's so many major record labels that they own other labels, and
sure.
That's, you know, Capitol is one of them. They have Capitol Label Group. Then you have like Brentwood Label Group, Provident Label Group. You have
right.
You know, and all those labels are right here in Nashville. I know they have different divisions in LA, New York, and things like that, but all those are right here in Nashville, but no one thought to do Nashville Label Group. And, you know, Nashville is not only is it Music City, but it is like the fifth fastest growing city in the United States of America.
Right.
You would
yeah.
think somebody, you know, would want to brand that, and especially being Music City. So we did, and we own it, and that's too bad for anybody else.
Right. No, I hear you there, man. And nice going. That's awesome.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Well, it's exciting. You know, these artists that we're signing and releasing are, man, artists that we believe in. We know that they have a heart for God, but we also know they rock and in their respective genres. And we just couldn't be more happy than to have these guys on our label, and we'll be signing new artists as well this year.
Cool.
So there'll be a lot to be. Definitely want to keep up with NashvilleLabelGroup.com, and like I said, that'll be up within the next 3 weeks, and it'll have both Rockfest and Burtonwood Records on there. But until then, BurtonwoodRecords.com and RockfestRecords.com.
Sweet.
They're up, and both of them say coming soon, I think.
Nice, nice. Cool. Sounds great, man. Sounds great. Well, dude, before I let you go, I mean, there's one thing that I always like to ask people, and I know that the answer changes sometimes, but at this point, you know, you're running a record label, getting it all started up, you're in a band that's been around for, you know, like, what, almost two decades? I mean, it's been a long time. You guys have been rocking it out for a while.
Yeah, 20 years.
With all this stuff, what would you say at this point in your life is the most un-rock and roll thing about you?
The most un-rock and roll thing about me is, there's so many, but I would think the fact that my wife and I, snuggle to watch, to binge watch, Longmire is probably the most un-rock and roll thing. Not snuggling with my wife, Lori, but the fact that we're watching Longmire, and I'd heard of that show before, and I never watched it because it just didn't seem like something I'd watch. But
right,
I started watching, and I was like, man, and I love it because we pick shows that the series has already ended. You know what I mean? And because I hate waiting for the next. Anybody that knows me knows I like to get things done. I like to move quick. And I when we watch shows where I have to wait till the next week, it's like dun dun dun. I'm like ah. And so, but we snuggle and we just finished Longmire, now we're going to move on to another series. We'll find one. But that would probably be the most un-rock and roll thing is me like sitting, snuggling with my wife and watching Longmire.
Cool deal, man. Well, dude, I like Longmire too. I'm only about, I think I'm just starting the second season or so. But yeah, I enjoy it. It's fun. It's not the fastest moving show, but it's there's something kind of cool about it.
Yeah, well, everybody dies in the end.
Oh, thanks, buddy. Thanks.
Chewbacca dies in the end.
Right. Oh, man.
No, it's great, man. It's a great show. So.
Sweet deal, man. Sweet deal. Well, cool deal. Well, is there anything else that you want to add? I feel like we've hit on most of the things I wanted to, but if there's anything else that you want to throw out there, feel free.
I just say real quick that anybody that's listening and hearing this and, you know, maybe you're going through a tough time. I don't know what you've done in your life, what you've been through in your life, but I can tell you this, that that where I was as a drug addict, homeless, no hope in my life, to being where I'm at now was a tough journey. But I'm telling you, God was with me every step of the way, and no matter how disappointing life has been to you in the past, and no matter how many times you've even failed in the past, I want to tell you that you can do it, man. And that it's you have to let go of things that you have to let God have every area of your heart, every area of your heart, every area of your life. And man, I'm telling you, don't give up. Keep going for it. God didn't just do this for me because I'm awesome, you know, and I sing for a Christian rock band. God will do this for any of us. And maybe it's not a label. Maybe it's something else that you're doing, or maybe it's not a band, whatever. You don't have to be the lead singer of a Christian rock band or own a record label for God to use you. He can use you right where you're at, doing big things. But man, you got to trust him, and you can't give up. I would just encourage people in that. Like you haven't done too much in your life to be forgiven and to do big things for God.
Sweet deal, man. Dude, I couldn't have said it better myself. Thank you so much for your time, Joseph. It's always a pleasure to get to chat with you, and I hope people get a chance to check out the new record and, of course, to see the tour and to look forward to what Rockfest and Burtonwood are going to be doing in the near future as well.